going to Charleston, back where I belong.
Please, please take me with you.
No. I'm through with everything here. I want peace. I want to see if somewhere there isn't something left in life of charm and grace. Do you know what I'm talking about?
No. I only know that I love you.
That's your misfortune.
Red, if you go, where shall I go? What shall I do?
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
In July of 1896, William Cameron Menzies was born in New Haven, Connecticut. Being a simple New England boy, William served in the United States Army during the First World War. Upon his return home, William continued his education at the University of Edinburgh, and soon after studied at the Art Students League in New York. Not long after, William Menzies found work designing silent movies at United Artists and Famous Players, which eventually became Paramount. His early work included Thief of Baghdad. Menzies began to become known through Hollywood as a pioneer in special effects and design. His hard work proved him capable to stretch the limits of contemporary film design. He designed and engineered state-of-the-art special effects that dazzled critics and captured the imagination of his audience. After working in the big studios through the early 20s, William became an independent artist and teamed up with big Hollywood names. He was also the first person to be accredited with the title production designer, giving him individual responsibility of creating the overall look of a film. Took off. He designed 4 films in 1925 and 4 in 1926. In 1927, he did 5 films, 6 in 1928, 9 in 1929, and 10 films in 1930. William was recognized in the first Academy Awards when he won an Oscar for the Best Art Direction for The Dove in 1927 and The Tempest in 1928. The 1930s marked a new era for the film industry as technology developed to record and sync sound into the movies. His last silent film was Sadie Thompson in 1928, before he moved on to dialogue films. William kept designing into the 30s. He designed the American classic Gone with the Wind. He created everything, from the elegant housing to the beautiful landscapes, to the climactic scene of the burning of Atlanta. He engineered the collapse of the buildings and the intensities of the flames in this masterful scene. Interestingly enough, the scene was shot in order to clean out the 40-acre lot of old sets in the back of MGM Studios. Among the flames was the giant walls used in King Kong. Thank you.
We'll be right back.